Hello, this is Jose Luis here, and in this video I would like to teach you how to animate a grasshopper slider so that you can generate frames for an animation and then take that animation and generate like a GIF or generate a video, etc., etc. The way that's going to work is I have this grasshopper definition that I made in my previous video on this series, which is a windswept patch of grass. So what we have is a surface with a lot of curves that are growing out of them and that representing, for example, grass. And what I have is this one slide that they represent time. And as time goes by, you can see that we create an animation effect where the wind is blowing over the grass with this very interesting ripple effect. Imagine like a field of wheat with a very strong wind blowing over it. And what I want to do is I want to take this that I'm seeing right here on my screen, and I want to actually create an animation that I can share with colleagues, that I can post on social media, whatever that is. So Grasshopper actually has a way of creating these kind of animations automatically, which is the following way. So if I right click on a slider, you can see that there is an animate option. And if I click on the animate option, you can see that there's a bunch of things that I can choose. For example, I can choose where in my computer the frames are going to go, and I'm going to choose a folder called animation on my desktop. And what this is going to do is it's going to take screenshots of this screen, especially if I click on this button, so that I adapt the size and the resolution of my screenshots to my current viewport here. So if you want a different viewport, you can maximize this. For example, if I want something like this, I can maximize my viewport, and now I can right click here, animate. And when I click here, you can see that the size of the resolution is now the same as the one I have in my viewport. And then what I can do is I can choose how many frames do I want. What Grasshopper will do is it will divide the full range of the slider in values that match how many frames do you want. And therefore it will automatically advance over this slider at those increments. So for example, if I say here, I want an animation that is going to be, for example, 10 seconds. And if the animation is 30 frames per second, I want, for example, 300 frames. Or let's do a 20 second animation. So that's going to be 600 frames. What I can do is I can now hit OK. And then what you can see is that Grasshopper is increasing this slider at tiny intervals, matching that frame rate that you specified. So you can see that it's now generating frames over and over, and it's actually taking a little bit of time. So it's taking about like 55 seconds left. So I'm just going to pause this, and then I'm going to turn back on when it's done. Okay, so it looks like it's about to finish. It's only like a couple seconds left. And boom, it's done, right? So now if I go to my desktop, you can see that on my desktop, I have a folder called animation that has a bunch of BMP files being those screenshots. And if I double click on the screenshot, you can see that the image that I get is this one, which is basically a screenshot of my viewport. And if I start scrolling through my image one at a time, you can see that I can take each one of them is one of the frames representing that motion for the animation of the slider. So I have 600 of these frames. So now with each one of these frames, I could take them to a video editing software like Adobe Premiere or After Effects or something like that. Or there are actually also a lot of online services out on the internet that you can just upload a bunch of images and they will generate an animation for you. So with this, now you can generate an animation however you want. I'm going to show you a really quick way of doing this with a command line tool, even though I'm not going to get into the details, but let me show you how I would do that, for example. So as I was practicing doing this, I actually realized that the tool that I use does not take BMP extensions for files. So what I ended up doing was I ended up exporting this again. But instead of doing BMP here, I used PNG, which is a different file format, even though at the end of the day, it ends up, when Grasshopper exports, it still ends up being BMP for real. It doesn't really use PNG. Anyway, but long story short, I had to do that hack on my own, but maybe you don't have to do that by yourself. But anyway, I had to render this again, and I ended up with a folder called Animation PNG, which has the same files, but in PNG format. What I like using a lot for this kind of generation of animations is a tool that is called FFmpeg. So FFmpeg, which is a command line tool for converting, re-encoding videos, etc. It's a really, really useful one. And it's a very, once you install it in your system, you can open a terminal on the folder, right? So I'm right now on the folder that I'm using, that I have all these animations, and I can say, I can call FFmpeg and say, for example, that I want to create a video at a frame rate of 30 frames per second. I want the input frames to be a series of files that are called frame underscore, and then I can use this special notation to say that after that, there are 5 decimal digits that are correlative. So I use this like a percentage sign, 0, 5, and D to indicate that there's a sequence of 5 digits. Then I type the extension of the file, and now the name of the outcome, which is going to be animation.mp4. And what this command line will do will be automatically go through all the frames and compose a video with all those frames in MP4 format with some default parameters. So you can customize the bitrate, etc., etc. But you can see that I have now this file here. And if I double click, you can see that I have an animation that is all the frames stitched together and very nicely. So you can see how smooth this animation is. And you saw that flickering. That's because while I was rendering, I turned off the visualization. So that's why, the thing is, like, when you do this screenshotting, Grasshopper will screenshot exactly what you have on the screen. So if you want to make a nicer screenshot, you can just turn off this grid, you can turn off the visualization of this point, you can hide the surface, and maybe you want to give it some style. Maybe you want to render one of these ambient occlusion kind of aesthetics. It's up to you, but whatever it looks like on Rhino, that's what it will look like on the screenshot. So I'm not going to get into FFmpeg as a tool, because that's going to be its own playlist at some point, because it's very useful and cool. But if you want to learn more, or if you want to have like a quick cheat sheet, I actually have on my GitHub repo, if you go to FFmpeg, I have a full list of commands that you can use to create videos from files, extract frames from a video, create a GIF from a video, speeding up video, compression, change the size, a lot of stuff. So you can look for my GitHub repo, FFmpeg cheat sheet, okay? If you want to learn more about that. Otherwise, this is creating animations. And otherwise, if you don't want to use FFmpeg, just take all those frames and use some video editing software to stitch them together and render a video. That's also absolutely fine, okay? All right, so this was creating animations from sliders. Thank you very much. Maybe if you like this video, just maybe like it, maybe not, whatever. Otherwise, see you on the next video on this series. Bye-bye, thank you.